Hello everyone. Today, we are going to study about journalism and social reforms. Have you ever had a thought, what are they? What do they mean? Probably no. I'll explain this to you. But before jumping directly to the topic, we will learn what is journalism. You can easily understand the term journalism by understanding its activities, that is, gathering, assessing, creating, and presenting news and information. It is a form of writing that is usually different from all other forms of writing. This tells people about things that has really happened and about which they may not be already aware. It is also very important to know about those who follow journalism. So, the people who follow or write journalism are known as journalists. They might work in newspaper organizations, magazines, websites, television, or on radio stations. Now, let us learn about social reforms, which is the second part of your topic. You might have heard this term in your civics book in school. Let us recall it. Social reforms are the movements which include public involvement, which aims to bring a gradual change or change in certain aspects of the society, rather than rapid or fundamental changes. Social reforms are the movements which are different from more radical movements, such as revolutionary movements. You can also understand social reform as a group of people belonging to common ideology who try to achieve certain goals together. You might have heard about the motto, "Together we can." Social movements depend on the togetherness of the people. Usually their common goals are bringing down the crime rate, bringing down poverty. They talk about increasing employment opportunities and also about increasing economical and financial standards of people. Now, let us try to understand journalism and social reforms together in the context of word. For this, I have a short case study which explains how the journalism has brought a socio-political revolution. Here is it. In the second half of the 18th century, newspapers revealed about the political unsettlement in the 13 colonies of North America, which led to an upspring from different sections of the society. These colonies were New Hampshire, Massachusetts, Connecticut, Rhode Island, New York, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Delaware, Maryland, Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina, and Georgia. This movement was led by Benjamin Franklin in Philadelphia and Isaiah Thomas in Massachusetts, etc. They led this to converge their ideologies and principles so that the draconian law of British would be uprooted from the colonies. In this, media surpassed all the boundaries of class and connects merchants, farmers, policymakers, officials, sailors, women, marginal workers and all other members of the society. Hence, the colonies joined together to get freedom from British Empire and came together to become United States of America. After this case study, you must know about the connection between journalism and social reform in Indian context. With the help of two different examples, I'll tell you what is the connection between journalism and social reform in Indian context. So, the example one is about the great social reformer Raja Ram Mohan Roy and his contributions. In early 19th century, Raja Ram Mohan Roy opposed social evil like sati pratha, caste system, idol worship, and animal sacrifices, etc. He published his very famous newspaper, Samvad Kaumudi, in order to spread awareness about these social evils which were being practiced in the society on regular basis. And because of his contribution, social evil like sati pratha was banned from being practiced permanently. Now, let us go through the second example. This is about one of the very famous reformer, political leader belonging to Manipur, that is Hijam Irabot. Hijam Irabot published a magazine named as Mititi Chanu in the year 1922. In this, he wrote about political subjugation, economic exploitation, and religious oppression, etc., of the mass by the British imperialists and Brahma Sabha patronized by the kings at that time. He also led several other movements which provoked the already victimized people in demand for self-rule in Manipur against the British government. So, this is all about journalism and social reforms. While writing your answers, you can also add example from Indian independence movement because it also has huge contribution of journalism into it. I hope this has helped you in understanding the topic. Thank you so much.